So maybe let's take one step outside, because we have seen the car, we looked at the range anxiety, we looked at the economics of the car. But from a very broader perspective, from a broader economic perspective, what do you think that electric vehicles can do for our economy, and what will be the change in the business models from a country perspective, right? Why should we go towards that?
I think that the contribution, especially to energy transition, the transition to renewable energies, is really huge. And I would like to say that, for example, the storage capacity of electric vehicles, now the best ones is about 100 kilowatt hours for vehicle, can mean a huge capacity for storing the energy from the wind or solar or other sources from renewable energies. And this contribution can be huge, and also cost saving can be also important. For example, if I calculate that we have now more than 7 million vehicles in the Netherlands, and if 1 million from them will be electrical vehicle with the huge capacity of 100 kilowatt hours, then we are coming to the capacity of 100 gigawatt hours. And now the peak power in Netherlands is about 35 gigawatts. So we can cover the whole country energy needs for more than 3 hours by energy vehicles. Of course, you need to have a technology for that. For example, a vehicle to grid. We are developing at the University in Delft such a technology. But this is something which will change the whole landscape. Also, for the private user, it can be that the houses or the user can be more energy neutral.
Electric vehicles are 3 to 4 times as efficient as a combustion vehicle in practice. So you're saving a lot of energy. And if you make an electric vehicle capable for storing energy or even harvesting energy, like the startup company Lightyear is planning to do, it's earning money, standing still, and maybe even driving. Self-driving vehicles are earning money anyhow. 50% of the cost of transportation is the chauffeur. So in some cases where you don't need a chauffeur, you can stimulate or build your economy much easier than we did in the past. The nice thing of electric vehicles is that they are also the platform for automation. I've already talked about driverless vehicles, autonomous vehicles. They're easy to automate and easy to connect to each other. So road trains, completely driverless, or accidents can be avoided, traffic jams can be avoided by automation. So that's a very important economic value for the future. And if you add that up, electrification, automation, and maybe even sharing, that we make smarter use of the capacity of passenger cars or trucks. Trucks are driving for more than 50% empty. That's no transportation, I would say. Then you could imagine that during this century, apart from the investment, that the transportation cost of man and good could be for free. And that is saving a lot of cost, and cost and money is what is available for other more added value business. And we shouldn't forget, Margot already said, that we are the pioneers in the charging infrastructure. For the Netherlands, there is a lot to gain with exporting that idea and that experience. And we are the world leaders in normal charging and fast charging at this moment in time. On the other hand, even in the trucks and buses, we are leading in Europe. And having the European activity of Tesla in the Netherlands is also very important. I think Europe has still to understand, because it has a lot of stake in the old car economy, that it should move and that it should renew. Otherwise, we lose our economic wealth, but also our health at the end. So I think electric mobility is an enormous opportunity to stimulate the next economy.
Well, Frank, I'm impressed. What can I add to this? I think what we see is that the contribution of electric mobility to our economy has many different aspects. Pavel already mentioned public health. You said you can't express that in, you know, economic terms, but of course it is being expressed in economic terms. And it may sound very cynical, but, you know, preventing premature deaths that are caused by bad air quality does contribute to the economy. You know, healthy people that live longer can contribute more to the economy and to society.
I think the human life is priceless, and I have difficulties to put a price tag on it.
I'm not saying that I disagree with you, but this is, you know, it's a cynical reality. We should also not underestimate to what extent clean air may become an important factor to attract talented people and innovative businesses to our cities. You know, it's both are key to economic growth in the future. And many cities have already established environmental zones with restricted access for the most polluting vehicles. Many cities are seen, you know, to be eager to reclaim public space for pedestrians and for cyclists. And I can easily imagine in the near future that city centers are going to be places where you can only move around, if not by, you know, bike or walking, where you can only move around with, you know, electric mobility. As municipal governments are all striving to improve the livability of our cities. You also pointed out that there are many more, you know, direct contributions of electric vehicles to our economy. I already mentioned jobs. You know, there are so many new technologies involved. There is a whole range of new IT-intensive services being developed. You know, I probably don't know them all. You know, one of the simplest is the new app that was developed to show cars drivers where charging poles are available. There is great economic potential for electric vehicles to play a role in the new energy system, in accommodating the variability of renewable energy sources in the future electricity system. And that development is also, you know, it's nothing but a revolution. The electric vehicles becoming an active component of the electricity system. That also will require a lot of innovations in terms of, you know, new services, new market developments, new transactions. You know, it's very exciting to see what research groups around the world are doing develop applications of, for example, blockchain technology, and to accommodate the almost real-time interactions of electric vehicles that are being recharged with the electricity system. That is only part of the interaction between electric vehicles and the electricity system. So, a whole world of new technological options and needs is unfolding here.
I'd like to stress one thought which was already mentioned here, but I'd like to stress it again, that only when we charge electric vehicles by energy from the sustainable sources like solar and wind, only then we have a real sustainable solution. This is a very important part, and again we will mention in technology and future mobility part of the MOOC, but this is something which we have to keep in mind all the time, that this is an important part of the solution, of the equation for energy transition.
So we see electric vehicles are a key technology for the future, and they're going to have a tremendous impact on the society, on our economy, on the environment, and at the community at large. And while you cannot charge gasoline or diesel vehicles from solar wind energy, you can do that with electric vehicles. So that makes them a sustainable transportation mode for the future.